सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। सर्वे वेदा यत्पदमामनन्ति तपागंसे सर्वाणि च यद्वदन्ति यदिच्छन्तो ब्रह्मचर्यं चरन्ति ते पदगम संग्रहेण ब्रवीमि। ओमित्येतत् एतद्देवाक्षरं ब्रह्म एतद्देवाक्षरं परम् एतद्देवाक्षरं ज्ञात्वा यो यदिच्छति तस्य तत् एतद्देवाक्षरं ब्रह्म एतद्देवाक्षरं परम् एतद्देवाक्षरं ज्ञात्वा यो यदिच्छति तस्य तत् यो यदिच्छति तस्य तत्। दी 14th वर्स विच इज द क्वेश्चन ऑफ नचिकेतस। एक्चुअली इज ओनली इंडिकेटिंग आवर डिजायर ऑफ सेटलिंग डाउन। We all have some desire to settle down. And when I think, what really is the meaning of settling down? So, two, three things come in my mind. First thing that comes, that there should be some situation or something. People are vague in there, they don't know their desires or they do it vaguely. Supposing somebody is married, then they say, have you settled in that marriage? You go to a new job, they say, have you settled in the new job? So what I think is the meaning of settling is in 14th verse. How is it? Let us see that from one more angle, then I'll go to another verse. First thing is that settling down, I don't have to do any work. There should come a time in our life where doing a work should be an option, not a compulsion. It's not mandatory. And even if I see somebody doing work and getting some reward, I should not be feeling he is getting. Therefore, I should also do to prove myself. So, we want to settle means first thing is I don't want to be under pressure of lot of work. I don't want to live a life where every day I am morning till evening I have lot of work to do. Number one point. Number two point in their settling down. Various situations come, I should not be happy, sad, upset with the situation. I should be a little away from the situations. I should not be persecuted by this situation or lifted by the situation. Nothing can make me sad about anything, or I'm not very happy about any big thing that has happened in the situation. Nobody has now capacity to give me any positive or negative feelings in my mind. Second thing about settling down. Not that today this has happened, I am very much influenced. Tomorrow this has happened. I have situations, outer world or not. I have no say on my state. And third thing about settling down is that I don't have lot of modification in me. I am established in my own self. These three things which are mentioned by Nachiketa, that which is beyond doer, beyond dharma and dharma, is I want to leave all karta. You think of that. When any work comes, you want to complete the work. And the reason behind complete the work is not to complete the work. You want to get out of the doer of that. Some doer is sitting, actually speaking, you want to get rid of the doer. To get rid of the doer, you want to complete the work. That let me finish this work. And after completing, you are free. Not from the work, but this internal doer actually. Some people say, I like to work. You like to work to complete the work. And not to keep the work pending. You are not very comfortable with the doer actually. To have a doer is not a great experience what I have felt. But Maya is such, it shows joy in doer. That I have, because doer is the one that gets rewards. Doer gets medals. Doer gets praises. And through doer I can show that how I was better than that person, I did better than him, I got first class. Through doer I am known in the society. And when somebody meets, what is the question? What is your name? Next question, what you do? And if you say nothing, I am following Nachiketa. So he will say before going in Chinmay mission, you are okay. You are normal. What happened to you? Dhyan dena, lot of thinking is required and your problem is thinking. Therefore, we have to think rightly. Somebody said, only Swamiji, you are in the Vedanta classes. There is a lot of intellectual only. I said, but your problem is intellectual. Not that we won't work, we will work after that. It is after hearing satsang classes, Gita, you are well equipped to work outside. I was reading, you know, the Prime Minister, etc. goes around them, there are commandos. They are called black cats. Have you seen them? So all have put dark glasses. If you have seen. Dark glasses. And one has one suitcase with him. Behind him, if you have noticed. Dress also black, and he has a dark glass like that. And all of them same dark glasses. And one will carry one suitcase, a small briefcase, everywhere. I used to wonder why this person carries suitcase, clothes are there, what is the problem he has? Some tiffin is there, toothpaste and brush is what he has kept. Then when I found, they say their glasses are there so that any blast is there, it will not immediately go on his eyes. Number one, his eyes will be unaffected. And that glass is a special glass, through that he can see more than other people also. More than other people. He can, and where he is seeing, others won't know also. So if you either constantly scanning like that, but you won't know where he is seeing. So that the one who is trying to attack, he won't know that I am already spotted. That dark glasses. And about the suitcase, it is not a suitcase. It is a, what is it called? There is a cover. If somebody attacks, so it is a bulletproof cover. Immediately it will open it like that, threefold. And it will cover the Prime Minister. So scriptures, you will still work, but you will have special glasses so that you can see properly everything in perspective. And if any situational blast is there, so you still, your capacity to see will be right there. So three things I feel Nachiketa is asking, which we think, what is beyond the doer? Because we want to do something. I told you, the big cause, doer is sitting its own satisfaction and doer is recognized in the society. Because of the doer, you get married. If the girl is marrying a boy, first question is what the boy does. Society does not know all these things. You can't say, no, he is beyond krit and akrit, or he is beyond dharma and adharma. And why is he marrying? That is also not there. So he gets, you get immediate recognition. Supposing you say, no, I am working in that company, big company. I am CA. Okay, CA, yes. And in that particular firm is there. Deloitte I am working. So what is your role there? We are in Deloitte. I am the chief manager there. Sure. Please sit down. Whole perspective changes. Society has another kind of eyes to see you. Whole perspective changes seeing them. Just one line you said and everybody will be different. And if you say, no, how much have you studied? Not much, just metric. Oh, okay. देखा ना, उसके पास एक ही स्केल है, there only one scale, what you do, how you earn, how much you are there. So this doer is highly respected and awarded. Similarly, for everything is there. But actually speaking, and there is no limit, you do and attain something, to maintain that post, you have to really work a lot. Supposing you got something, you got a salary, you got. Now to maintain it, you really have to work a lot. Job appears good as long as you are out of that job. So grass is greener on the other side. Moment to enter into the system, you see the demands. And you will always feel he is giving me lesser salary than what I am working for. This is the discovery. Please note, I am not saying don't do. I am saying don't be dependent on the doer. Bhagwan Krishna also did, Ram Bhagwan also did. But they were not dependent on the doer. This doer is like that. Second, krit akrit is situational rest. Because effect is the situation, is the effect of my karma. And third, I want to go beyond kal, that means beyond any modification. So these three things I feel is called settling. And remember, no, you cannot settle in situation. I think I told while explaining Moksha Purushartha, you cannot settle in any person. You cannot say I'm settled with this person forever. That person who is unsettled, how can you settle in that person? Woody person supposing is there. Every person has mood. And I am settled on a person. I am settled on a wife who is little moody. He will be there. Now how can I be settled on unsettled thing? Here actually there is nothing called permanent job. Even permanent job is temporary. You say it's a permanent job, but you use a relative term. It's a temporary job only. So on temporary thing, how can you have permanent settlement? So three things. That means you can rest and rest only in the self or in the God. And therefore in Ramayana, when Bhagwan Ram, somebody said, name of Bhagwan has to be kept. Vasishtha ji kept the name. Yu Anand Sindhu Sukhrasi Seekar Tetra Lok Supasi So Sukdham Ram Asnama Akhil Lok Dayak Vishrama. Who is Ram? The drop of whom whole world is full of joy. And he is the one who gives rest to everybody. Because you get rest in your own self only. Rest anywhere you find, you will be tired. Sitting in one pose, you are tired. Eating one food, you will be tired. Living with one person, you will be tired. With your disease, you will be tired. But you will never be tired. Well, I am tired of my Atma. That is not possible. Because tiredness is where you are not able to do something which you want to do. What is tiredness? Supposing I say I am tired of you. Means what? I have a doer. I want you to do something. And you are not do. I am not able to do. Then I will say I am tired of you now. But if I don't have a doer with respect to you, I won't say I am not tired. I am already resting in myself. So there is nothing called tiredness. Okay. So this mantra of Nachiketa is very poignant and significant in its implications. Now the answer which was given by Yamaraj ji. Yamaraj ji? Yamaraj bolo. Yamaraj ji bolo. Kya Yamaraj bolo? Okay. So he is given. Three lines are for praise of that Brahman. And last is, I am telling that pad. Pad means what is attained, what is worth attaining, and what is attainable in this life is called pad. Like you heard, tat padam darshitam yena. Guru Stotra have you by hearted, all of you? Guru Stotra. All Guru Stotra, but you keep on chanting with the grace of Guru, you will have all knowledge. Therefore, Guru Stotra chanting should be done once in a day. So, that was Tat Padam Darshitam Yena, Tat Padam Darshitam Yena. So, that Padam has meaning, there are two meanings, Padyate Anin and Padyate Iti. So, what is attainable? Tat Padam. What is that pad? Om Sangrahena. Sangrahena means monosyllable. Monosyllable. Shortest indication. Say something in extreme brevity is there. Okay. Now he is saying, what is that Om? Okay, is it clear? No? It's clear. Etad hi eva aksharam brahma. So if you know little Sanskrit later on, you can break it. You can say etad, then hi, then eva aksharam, etad eva aksharam brahma. Etad hi. So e becomes ya. What is the rule? Iko yanachi. There is one sutra called Iko Yanachi. What is it, Japanese or what? No. So, this is beautiful sutras are there. It is called Iko Yanachi. I like those sutras. Shashchoti, like that. Anyway. I'm just telling so that you will later on. I'm trying to do so you get tempted by to read Sanskrit. Tempted. You may move 1 inch, but keep on moving. Etad is for Onkar. That Onkar. Only this is, I'm just translating, then I'll explain. It is very important to understand. Etad hi ev aksharam brahma. This is aksharam brahma. Between akshar and brahma, you can just put a pointer and write aparam brahma. It is aparam brahma. Upper in Sanskrit is lower in English. Yeah, what? I get confused. What? Upper in Sanskrit is lower in English. Okay. Got my point. Like calm word is there, calm. So Sanskrit calm means desire which disturbs, but it is not English calm. So Sanskrit calm is very disturbing, but English calm is very quiet. He was a calm person. Okay. So this is etad hi, this alone is aparam brahma. Aparam brahma. Acha? I'm just translating. Only what is aparam brahma? Wait, hold on. Have patience in life. If you don't have patience, you'll become patient. Etad hi ev aksharam param. This is param brahma. Who? Nachiketa. Not Nachiketa. Om. Oh, sorry. So this Omkar is a param brahma and this alone is param brahma. Okay. Then what you have to say more? Etad hi ev aksharam gyatva. Having known this is tva pratyaya is there in Sanskrit. Having known tva, like kratva, gyatva, it, gyatva. Having known this, here known means having meditated on that. Dhyatva is the word. What happened? Yo yadichhati tasya tat. Yo yadichhati tasya tat. Whatever he wants, he get it. So what has been said here? 3 points has been said. This Omkar is the aparam brahma and this Omkar is the param brahma. And third point, one who does upasana, I will add one more word, or he has the knowledge of Omkar, he attains that lok, or he attains the highest, or knows the highest. Now let me clear first what is aparam brahma and what is param brahma. And after that, it will be clearer. But don't be afraid of this word. Shall I use the Sanskrit aparam brahma or English? Sanskrit one. So don't confuse with English upper. Sanskrit upper, in English lower. And param is param. Param is, what is it called? Superior. One is superior one, other is inferior Brahma. Well, why is inferior? Arre, wait, I'm telling you. Wait, hold on. Okay. Now get 1-2 principles. What is param Brahma? Virat, you have heard. You have heard Virat. One day I told about Virat in the second boon. Now today you have to know what is Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha. I had told I will tell one day. What is Hiranyagarbha? Hiranyagarbha. So what is Hiranyagarbha? So understand this. It is nothing mysterious. Don't make mystery has no place in Vedanta. Mysteries, some experience, my experience was there and all these things have no value. As I came out of my room, Swamiji, I saw some udad dal. Why didn't you eat? No, it was not for that. It was just raw udad dal and some hairs. Oh, अच्छा outside my room, udad dal hairs were there and one small bone was there. So somebody is doing some black magic. Arey, black magic. Dog must have brought the bones from somewhere. No, you don't brush off everything. These things happen. Okay. What happened then? How are you feeling? I am feeling fine. Then black magic, nothing is happening. On whom? Who he did? So these things, don't get carried away by all these things. You know what happens when you are educated? One thing I have noted, when you are well educated, you are graduate, BSc, BA, BCom, you become little rational and you get above it slightly. Those who are not, they are carried away by all these things too much. Unnecessarily superstitions is there. Superstition means there something which is not provable also. It is non-confirmable. If he has so much of power, why can't he use that power and be quiet? That person who has done, what power he has? Now, please understand, very, very important principle, but it is very useful for everybody. Like I am talking. So, talking is preceded by the thought in the mind. I cannot talk unless I think. Even if to talk nonsense, the thought has to come. To talk wrong, wrong thought should be preceding the wrong thought, wrong talk. Supposing I am writing, Hari Om, I have to write Hari Om. So when you start your day, first letter should be Om. I don't like write Arisamaji Om, Om, not that Om, like this Om. What my point? When you starting your day, and first letter you have to write initially, write Om on the top. Not in your exam, etc. Just I'm saying, yeah. So exam copy, you write Om, exam, there is confused, what is this? Anyway. Then mentally you can chant Lord's name. So I am talking preceded by a thought. Not proceeded by, preceded by, before that thought came. And before thinking, it was an impression on my mind. That is expressive. Okay. Three stages. So, externalizing, internalizing and impressing. Three stages are there. Externalizing. Second is internalizing. And third is impressing. Impressing. Supposing you are walking. You walk to your room. So, before you walk, there was a thought of walking. You walk later on. First you thought, let me go to my room, keep my books, then come for dining hall. Let me keep all my books. And I'm feeling very hot, take out my sweater also. So these few thoughts came and then you started walking. My question is, this hall is made, so this hall architect had made first in his mind. That is called blueprint. My question is there something external possible without being coming in the mind? Is there something external possible without internalizing it in the mind? Wrong or right, I am not asking. It is not possible. So everything has to be preceded by a set of thoughts only. No external thing can come unless there is a well-structured thought about that subject. Okay. This mic, thought must be there of mic before somebody made this company. So first they have a blueprint. The factory who made is not. There is a R&D department. Research development. So first they design the mic on the computer. The mind they made, this size will be there, that will be there, this is to be there. Nobody that somebody came and just designed the mic without thinking. It is not possible. Is it okay? This desk is there, which you are using, and you are not taking, good, you are not taking in your rooms. This desk was there. So before that desk was made, somebody had dimensions in the mind.
this is dimension and this is how disk will be there. Be careful by opening and closing, otherwise this can hit you also. This the stand of that, it must have hit you by, see. If you are in a hurry, it will get stuck up, and in this cold weather you will feel good. So I am saying this point. If this is the case, khub sochna, because these are the concepts. If your concepts are not good, you will struggle a lot in understanding the Upanishads. And there is where we need teachers. Because these things are not written. Ab he mentioned Apara Brahma. Ab where is the explanation of other Apara Brahma? Hum kahan se bataye? Either it is in the commentary. Because they think these people who are reading already are knowing everything. Ab here we don't know anything. If this whole world is made, it should be in thought form or not? Before it was made. Whole world, sun, moon, star, millions of jeev is there. Like you have a thought body. Your thought body nobody is seeing. People are seeing your external body. When Narad ji was given the body of the monkey in Ramayana, he asked Bhagwan, why did you give me the body of monkey? He said, I did not give you any new body. That was your thought body. Your shape, because you were liking to marry that girl, like a monkey you were jumping. So I gave you the form of your thought body. So you are externally appearing as human being, but internally you are not all the time like that. Internally become monkey, internally become fox, as cunning as a fox. Sometimes we become like a snake. Sometimes we are a simple, but like a cow, he is like a cow. Sometimes we are parai buddhi, like a dog. Why you are barking like a dog? Say like that. He is so cruel, like a leopard. There is one text, I forgot the name, it is in Banaras Hindu University. It says that what forms mind, mind takes the form of an animal. So there is a thought body. Similarly, before this world was made, there is a thought body. And the owner of that thought body, possessor of that thought body, who says this is my thought body and my thought, he is called Hiranyagarbha. Please don't translate it as golden egg. Be very, very careful about that. Hiranyagarbha means what? How will you translate this Hiranyagarbha? Garbha means inside. Garbha means inside. So sarvagyatvam anteyasya bahubrihi samas. Omniscience is in whose womb? In itself. Here womb is a figurative expression. Womb doesn't mean something, some womb is there. Womb means inside. Inside of that there is omniscience. Sarvagyatvam garbhe ante yasya. Ante, garbha means ante. In the inside of whom there is omniscience. And the possessor of this body is called Hiranyagarbha. Oh, I understand. Very difficult, Swamiji. And what difficult is there? Hiranyagarbha, what difficulty is there? No, but I can't see that. Arey, bhai, understand first. See later on. Sarvagyatvam garbhe ante yasya. Omniscience is in whose womb? Okay. That means all the thoughts are there about all pranis, all jeev, all future, all sun, all star, and my life also. About my thought, my life also, thought is there. Yes. And then it must be disturbing thought. Where? In the Hiranyagarbha, if my thought is also included in that Hiranyagarbha, I'm so disturbing person. See, in front of so quietening, little disturbing doesn't matter, don't worry. So, mean to say, whatever I am thinking is a thought in the Hiranyagarbha. That you mean to say, I don't have exclusive mind. No. My mind is a part of that mind. That means the one who possesses that mind called Hiranyagarbha, he must be very big. He knows all thoughts. Like you know all your thoughts. That means he also sees my thought as his thought. Yes. He is a possessor of all thought. Therefore, don't say it's my original thought. It is his thought only. That is called Hiranyagarbha. Technically, in Saguna Sakar, he is sometimes given the name as Brahma also. Is it clear? And therefore, he is very powerful also. Very powerful. Why? Because he creates anything after that. The thought converts into object. The thought converts into object. And therefore, if you think something which is against Hiranyagarbha, if you try to bring that thought and live an individual life, one part, your thought are Hiranyagarbha thought. Got my point? And now you are entered and you are neglecting the joy of that whole Hiranyagarbha thought. Now that Hiranyagarbha, because you are neglecting the whole joy, so he will try to see that you fail and that thought goes away. You fail and that thought goes away, so that if the part is disturbing the whole, then I try that part should be cut off. And if you are supporting, then what to say? So this is called Aparabrahma. So in Aparabrahma, what comes? Hiranyagarbha. And Hiranyagarbha itself becomes the Virat. Virat. Don't ask what is Virat. Same Hiranyagarbha which was there in a thought form, it materialized. Materialized. Materialized means what? Indri gocharam bhavati. It becomes the object of senses. Like what is in your mind, I can't say that. But you talk, I can say, oh, you are thinking like that. Now I am going to make something for you, Swamiji. What? Surprise. See, don't give unpleasant surprise. No, I will give you pleasant surprise. Give me time. Achha? Okay, can I use the kitchen for 2 hours? No. Okay, can I make in my room? Room, how will you make? There is no stove. No, I brought from my home. You brought a stove or books, etc. Achha. Then, this person brought something. He brought one cake he brought. Achha. One cake he brought. He made one nice cake, round cake was there. And the name of this cake was SUP cake. Really, what is this SUP? SUP is self-unfoldment. No, it's not self-unfoldment. Then, the name of this cake is not self-unfoldment. Same universal peak cake. SUPK. And in that, designs are there. So that cake had a peak. You don't know such cakes exist. Cake need not be round all the time. You don't know this. Cake have different sizes also. They can be in the shoe size cake are also there. Shoe size cake is there. So Everest peak was there. The cake had Everest peak. This you made. Huh? Instead of writing notes. No. I made this. Now please get my point. When he talked to me 5 hours back, I did not know what he was in his mind. But that thought became indriya gochar. It became perceptible. So thought, how do you use the word? It got concretized. It has taken a concrete shape. So what was a concept has become concrete. So similarly, this Hiranyagarbha was a thought, but it materialized and it became Virat.